The ICEVI, the Nippon Foundation mathematics package for teachers. Let us define a subset, proper subset and improper subset. Now let us consider set A consisting of four elements 1, 2, 3, 4, and let us consider set B with two elements 2 and 4. Now what do we note here? Now here the set A has four elements and set B has two elements, and we can notice that the set A contains all elements of set B, because set A has 1, 2, 3, 4. Set B has 2, 4. So the 2, 4 of set B are already included in the set A. So that means we write B as a subset of A. That means B and subset is the horizontal U, where the arms of the U are pointing out to the set which has more numbers. So here A has four elements, B has two elements, so that means B is a subset of A. Now the set A can also be called as the superset. Now students in the class consist of boys and girls. So when you take set B as boys and set A as the students of the class, then boys will become a subset of the class. Similarly, when you take A as the class and B as the set of girls, then the B becomes a subset of the set A. So this is how we define the subset of a set. Now let us talk about the proper subset. The subsets other than the set itself are called as proper subsets. Now let us take A set, and then we have two elements in the set A, that is 1 and 2. So A is a set. Then what are the subsets of A? One subset is 1 itself. Another subset is 2 itself, because 1 belongs to the set A, 2 belongs to the set A. So 1 is a subset of A, 2 is a subset of A. Suppose we say B is a set with object 1, and then let us consider C as a set with object 2. Now B is a subset of A and C is also a subset of A. There is a possibility for one more set. What is that set? We call that as the null set. We call that as the null set. Null set should always be included when we talk about the subset. What is null set? We are indicating that it is a set, but there is no element. So it is an empty set. So empty set is also a subset of a set. So the set 1, 2 has three proper subsets. One is set B consisting of element 1. Second is set C consisting of element 2. And third is set D consisting of no elements, that is null set. So this is how we define proper subsets. Now let us define improper subset. What is improper subset? Well, when you say A is a set consisting of 1 and 2 as the elements, we call the set itself as an improper subset. So any set can be called as an improper subset too.